Greetings, my name is Charles McCall, and I am the Director of Mentoring Growing Leaders. And today we're going to start a short series. I'm going to try to be faithful and sharing a short series from this book. This is John Maxwell's book, and it's called Relationships 101, What Every Leader Needs to Know About Basic Relationships. Relationships 101. And so in this little booklet, there are eight short chapters. And I'm going to try to create a short video. Short video would be maybe 8 to 10 minutes on each one of these chapters. And so we're going to begin with lesson number one, chapter number one, Relationships 101, What Every Leader Needs to Know. Chapter one, lesson one, Why Are Relationships Important to Success? And I don't have the ability to edit these videos right now, so the slide comes in while I'm talking, but you will find on my Facebook, Charles E. McCall, M-C-C-A-U-L, you will find the slides posted on my Facebook wall. And so number one, lesson number one, chapter number one, why are relationships important to success? And John Maxwell, he begins by sharing about Mr. Ronald Reagan. Ronald Reagan was the 40th president of the United States of America, and he was president for two terms, 8 years. One term is 4 years. Two terms is 8 years in the United States. That's the maximum amount of time that a person can be president. And he was also governor of California. Between California and New York are the two states that have the most people in the United States. They're not the largest as far as land is, but New York and California are the two states who have more people than any other state. And so California is right there at the top. And he was president of all of the United States for 8 years. He was governor of all of California for 8 years. And some of his characteristics, he was an actor. He was a knuckle hound. He was an actor before he became a politician. And so Mr. Reagan had strong beliefs. He had some foundational beliefs that he built his life upon and lived upon. He loved his country, and he understood himself. He knew what his strengths were. He knew what his weaknesses were. And he was a very skilled communicator. He was able to communicate with people because he developed that skill. Communication is a skill that we can develop. And on my YouTube channel, I have Leadership 101, and I have several different lessons, and one in particular on developing skills with people. And I also have some lessons in the Cambodian language, I believe, in about communication, how to be a better communicator. But he was a good communicator, and he was honest. And this perception comes from a man by the name of Michael Deaver. Michael Deaver was Ronald Reagan's assistant for 30 years. And so he observed Ronald Reagan, and he observed these characteristics. He had strong beliefs. He loved his country. He understood himself. He was a skilled communicator, and he was honest. But Mr. Deaver goes on to say, but perhaps the most impressive thing about Ronald Reagan was his ability to relate to people. So even though he had strong beliefs, he was a great leader, he knew who he was himself, and had developed communication skills and all of that, Mr. Deaver says, probably his strongest characteristic was his ability to be able to relate to people. But here's something interesting. Mr. Deaver also says that, I forgot to put my microphone on for a moment. Mr. Deaver also says that Ronald Reagan was one of the shyest people he had ever met. And so some people who are outgoing, they're easy, they talk a lot, it's easy for them to make friends, they're not shy. It's easy for those people to build relationships with others and to have lots of friends. But for people who are introverts, who are shy, who don't ordinarily reach out to other people, it's more difficult. And so Mr. Deaver says that Ronald Reagan was actually a very, very shy person. And yet he was able to connect with everybody because he overcame his shyness. And he did what he needed to do when he needed to do it. He developed communication skills and he developed people skills. And I would like to refer you to my my lesson on developing people skills in my Leadership 101 course on my Mentoring Growing Leaders website. And Mr. Deaver also said, basically, Ronald Reagan liked people. He liked people. That's a good question for me and you. Do you like people? Do you actually like people? There are some people who don't like people. They prefer not to be around them. They have a negative perspective of them. But Reagan liked people. And he developed skills while he was a spokesperson for the General Electric Company. He traveled around and he gave presentations for the General Electric Company. And during those 10 years, he developed the skills necessary to relate to people because he was traveling around all over the United States. And he was meeting people from every class of society, from every level of society, and so he had to learn people skills. It's a very good lesson for us. Some of us may have weak people skills, but we can learn how to develop people skills. Again, take a look at that lesson that I have on developing people skills. I think it will help you a lot. And he truly cared about people at all levels. Ronald Reagan, President of the United States for two terms, Governor of the great state of California for two terms, spokesman for General Electric for 10 years, well-known actor, but he truly cared about people at all levels. He cared about people at the highest level, and he cared about people at the lowest level. He cared about the corporate executive, he cared about prime ministers and leaders from other nations, and he cared about the secretary and the janitor and the person that drove his car and opened the doors. That's a real key on developing people skills and relating to people. In 1975, a group gave the president a small bronze lion as a gift. Mr. Reagan spoke at their conference, and so they wanted to give him a little lion as a gift. It was bronze, made of bronze. And so Mr. Deaver was with him at that time, and Mr. Deaver said, "Oh, that's really nice. That's really a nice lion that they gave you there." And so Ronald Reagan said, "Yeah, it really is." And so Ronald Reagan kept it for 10 years. He kept it on his desk for 10 years. He really liked it. But after 10 years, Mr. Deaver was retiring. He was leaving, was no longer going to be working with Mr. Reagan any longer, President Reagan any longer. And so Mr. Reagan said, "Come here, I wanna give you a small gift. Come into my office, and I wanna give you a small gift just to show my appreciation after working with me for all of these 30 years and trying to think of what I might give you." And so Mr. Reagan turned around and he picked up from his desk that bronze lion. And he said, "I remember about 10 years ago, you said that you liked this, and I want to give it to you as a gift to show my appreciation for you." Mr. Deaver was amazed. He said, "I couldn't believe. I just made one comment. I said, yeah, that's nice. I like that." And after 10 years, Ronald Reagan remembered it, and he was kind enough to give it to him as a gift. And so, again, John Maxwell shares this with us as a testimony, as an example of a kind of person that knows how to build relationships with others. Just about everything that you and I do, it depends upon teamwork. In one way or another, we're working with other people. You may be the leader or you may be the follower. You may be the teacher or you may be the student. You may be the boss or you may be the employee. You may be the parent or the child, but you are probably involved with other people in many, if not most, areas of your life. And so therefore, it's important that we develop people skills, and it's important that we develop relational skills. And so again, in Maxwell's book, he gives us five ways of thinking and five ways of living in order to have good relationships with others. And so that's what we're going to look at briefly. Five ways of thinking and five ways of living to have good relationships with others. Number one is respect. And you can see my notes on my Facebook, or you can email me at charles.edward.mccall@gmail.com or mentoringgrowingleaders75@gmail.com. I'll put that down below this video. But number one is respect. Respect is giving value to others. You cannot make other people feel important in your presence if you don't really value them. And so respect is showing value to other people. You consider them important, whether they have a low position, somebody who picks up your trash, somebody who cleans your house, somebody who is a salesperson, or whether they have a high position. They're your boss, or they're the person who gives you your salary, or they're a dignitary in some way. You cannot make other people feel important around you if you don't feel that they're important. And so we show respect to other people before they earn that respect. Maybe they don't deserve the respect, but we give them the respect. Why? Because they have value as a human being. Every person, from the drunkard, the drug addict, the criminal, the beggar on the side of the road, the business person, the educator, the politician, everybody has value because they are a human being, and therefore we should give them respect, whether they earn that respect or not. The second characteristic is shared experiences. How do you develop relationships with others? By showing respect and by sharing experiences with them. That means you have to spend time with people, and you have to spend time with the same people a lot to build relationships with them. You have to have, we say, you have to have some history with them and some experience together of doing things together. And this may be work experiences. You're working together on a project. There's been so many people in my life where I've worked together on a project with them, and maybe it was just a short project, but because we've worked together, I have a connection with them. I feel good. They're my friend. I have a good relationship with them. Or it may be family experiences. It may be parents or children or relatives, and you do things. It may be recreational experiences. You go out and you have fun together. You eat together. You play together. But the point is, you spend time together and you share experiences. Sometimes, you know what? You can have bad experiences together, and those can bond you. The painful experiences that you go through with someone else, or you walk together as they go through it, that can bring you together and build close relationships. So we have to build time with other people into our busy lives. You must build time with other people into your busy lives to establish a relationship with them. Relationship 101. The third characteristic is trust. Without trust, you cannot have a long-term relationship. Trust comes from fulfilling your promises. Trust comes from being faithful to your word. Trust comes from doing what you said that you're going to do. And when trust is broken, it's very, very difficult to rebuild trust. And so be careful about your word and your honesty. And so you want to build trust with others so that when they trust you, then they feel like that they can have a closer relationship with you. They can walk with you. They can support you. You can accomplish a lot together. The fourth characteristic is what John Maxwell calls reciprocity. Reciprocity. An easier way to say that is give and take. And he says one-sided relationships do not last. If the person is the giver, and he never gets anything back, it's difficult to sustain a relationship like that. If you're the person that receives, you need to find some way to give back. There must be a give and take on both parties, on everybody involved, that we receive and we give back. We give and then we learn to receive back as well. And so if one person is always the giver and the other is always the receiver, eventually that relationship will get weaker and weaker. Each side must be willing to give and to sacrifice for the other side in order to receive from one another. So give and take is a key to building close relationships, strong relationships with others. Also along that, John Maxwell mentions, give people your full attention. When you're with them, don't be looking at your watch, don't be looking at your phone, don't be looking around. Focus on them and give them your full attention. attention. Show them that you care about them. Ask questions, look them in their eyes, give them feedback like, wow, that's interesting. Tell me more. Really? These are ways that we can connect with people, we show value to them, and we show that we're interested. This is the give and take part, is that they're giving to us, we're receiving, and then we're giving affirmation back to them. You can use the Ford technique to get to know people better. Ford is an acronym, F-O-R-D. F stands for future plans, O stands for occupation or work, R stands for recreation or fun, and D stands for dreams or hopes. And so you can ask questions. Maybe you're shy, maybe you're not a good communicator. You ask the questions. Tell me about your future. What do you want to do in the future? What do you want to be? What do you want to accomplish? Where do you want to go? You ask them about their future plans. O, you ask them about their occupation, their work. So what do you do for work anyway? Really? Tell me more about that. And you so ask more about their work and what they like about their work, what they don't like about their work, what the next level that they want to rise to. They're going to keep that job forever. They want to change. What else do they want to do in the future? R is recreation. So what do you like to do for fun? You like to listen to music. You like to watch movies. You like to go out in nature. And D is, what are your dreams? What are your hopes? What do you really have in your heart? If you could do anything that you could do, what would that be? You see, these are relationship building questions, F-O-R-D. And number five, the fifth characteristic for building relationships is mutual enjoyment. John Maxwell says, you must enjoy being with one another. You must enjoy being with the person. I'll be honest with you, there's some people I don't like to be with, and so I'm usually not with them. But there are others I really enjoy being with. You must enjoy fun things together. You must enjoy their company and joking together, their thoughts, their ideas, their caring for you and your ability to care back for them. And so you pay attention to others and you choose to be friendly. Mutual enjoyment. You pay attention to others and you choose to be friendly. In conclusion, how are you with relationships? Are relationships easy for you or are they difficult? What would you say is your weakest point in relationships? And how can you improve that? Think about it. Take some time. Write it down. How are you with relationships? Difficult for you? Easy for you? Are your relationships shallow? Are your relationships short term? Are they long term? Are building relationships easy or difficult for you? Why? Why is it easy? Why is it difficult? What is your weakest point in relationships? And how can you improve on that? What can you do? Another thought is, are you focused on yourself or others? When it comes to relationships, are you focused on yourself, always talking all the time? Always making them listen to you, not showing interest to them? You're always thinking about what's beneficial to you or what's beneficial for them as well. As a leader, you will receive huge benefits by developing your relationship skills with others. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you enjoy it, please subscribe to the channel. Please like the video and please click the little bell symbol so that you know the next time when I load up the next lesson to this. Thank you so very much. And also, if this has been helpful to you, share it with others.